Initial deployment, Vita Chamber. Client Orion Industries, stage one, each complete. Sinclair and Alexander tried to explain the science to me, but Suchong does not believe them. They keep saying plasmid reconstruction this and quantum entanglement that, and then poof, dead people come back to life. Bullshit! Of course, Ryan will only allow it to be tuned to his genetic frequencies for the testing.
Has overcome my final defense, and now he's come to murder me. In the end, what separates a man from a slave? Money? Power? No. A man chooses. A slave obeys. You think you have memories? A farm? A family? An airplane, a crash, and then this place. Was there really a family? Did that airplane crash, or was it hijacked? Forced down by something less than a man, something bred to sleepwalk through life until they are activated by a simple phrase. Spoken by their kindly master. Was a man sent to kill or a slave? A man chooses. A slave obeys. Come in. Stop. Would you guide me? Would you kindly? Powerful phrase. Familiar phrase.
Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Sit. Would you kindly? Stand. Would you kindly? Run. Stop. Turn. A man chooses. A slave obeys. Kill! A man chooses!
Obey!
Hurry now! Grab Ryan's genetic key! Now would you kindly put it in that goddamn machine?
Welcome to the city where you were born. You are angry at Fontaine, yes? Now you know the truth. You are his tool, brought back to Rapture to save him. You have saved many of my little ones. I owe you a debt. While you sleep, I undo some of Fontaine's mental conditioning. His control is no longer complete. can still pull some very unpleasant strings. We need your mind with many locks and keys. Fontaine has most of those keys, but not all. Su-chan designed your mind, taught Fontaine to control you. You might find answers in Su-chan's flat in Mercury Suite.
Who's he? He's the one who saved me.
Thank you.
Plasmid that can grow the spirit. Perhaps in your DNA, the secret lies. I've sent a little one with some goodies to help ease your burden.
Monster Fontaine's dug up. When she does speak, which is almost a never, her accent is thick and grating. Her hair is filthy and she seems to wear the same mustard stained jumper day after day. But I've got to hand it to Frank. The handball is the all-time diamond in the rough. No formal training, no experience, but she's more sad in the harpsichord.
Thank you. things to do.
Who's there?
No! No! No!
I don't like this any more than you do, kid. But you gotta understand where I'm coming from. I got 12 years down here. Big investment. Man can't walk away from a long con like that.
Things have gone buster between Fontaine and his little German bean hole. why a guy like Fontaine would waste his time with a spooky crowd when he could be getting the gravy from any dish he chooses is beyond the understanding of this paparazzi. Even reset the door code to 5744. Maybe to be double sure that info don't sprout up in his yard again.
The little monster Fontaine dug up. When she doesn't speak, which is almost a never, her accent is thick and grating. Her hair is filthy and the same jump up day after day. But I've got to hand it to Frank. Tenenbaum is the old-timer diamond in the rough. No formal training, no experience, but put her in front of a gene sequence and she's Mozart at the harpsichord.
Look at my home, torn apart by Fontaine and his wine. But I am sure there is answer in the John's flat. You will not believe me, but there was a time when we were all so beautiful.
That Tannenbaum ain't what you think. Florence Nightingale, huh? That'll all come crashing down for, you can say, canned tomatoes. I've seen good bunko, and I've seen great bunko. But when you waltz through Rapture and World War II without even a scratch, you got more than leprechauns watching over you.
All those years we thought we were making progress with our Skinner boxes and our electric shocks. What a waste of time. Until Adam, you could no more domesticate a child than a boa constrictor. Fontaine gives a such long history for child that he wants to imprint into child's head. Another person. A jukebox. Ready to play whatever tune Fontaine wants to hear. Fontaine's become some kind of boogeyman in Rapture. That myth gives him power. But peel back flim flam and a humbug, he's just another con man. And like all con men, he worries he'll end up on the wrong side of grief. That's why he commissioned a lot of 192. The antidote to the mental control plasmid. Fontaine said I better not tell anybody about the antidote. Not even Tenenbaum. And Su Chong is inclined to listen. All those years we thought we were making progress with our Skinner boxes and our electric shocks. What a waste of time. Until Adam, you can no more domesticate a child than a boa constrictor. Fontaine gives a such long history for child that he wants to imprint into child's head. Another person. A jukebox. Ready to play whatever tune Fontaine wants to hear.
Always secrets when with Su Chong, always secrets. He must have this lot 192 in his lab near Apollo Square. I once saw the dog running from my flat on the second floor. But those apes would have taken it back to Fontaine's pencil. I never knew what lot 192 was for, but Su Chong was doing something in secret.
Savings will happen. happily work out an affordable payment plan for any major procedure. Potentially terminal illnesses won't wait until payday. Should you...
Please,
Ryan's flesh and blood. Why'd I go to the trouble? Otherwise, you'd have been cut in two by the first security bot you crossed paths with. But not Ryan. He made it so his security would recognize his genetic structure. With half his genes, you ain't immune, but you got just enough to throw their metallic nukes off their game.
Fuck!
save one life is to save the world entire. I made a place for the children here, but it is you who are their savior. Will you stop here, or will you deliver them from this terrible city at long last?